Hello friends, in this session we are going to take up question 58 to 60 of class 8 Aryabhatta paper 2018 section D. So the question is, in the figure, A is a point in the interior of square PQRS. ABCR is also a square. If RC is equal to 27 cm and QB is equal to 28 cm, find the length of BS in centimeters. Now we know that CQ is equal to 28 plus 27. Why? Because they are given that ABCR is also a square. So this side will be 27. So this becomes 55 centimeters. Now RC is 27 centimeters. Now CRQ. Triangle CRQ and triangle ARS. So we have this triangle and we have this triangle. These two, if we compare, we know that angle A is equal to angle C equal to 90 degree. RS is equal to RQ, sides of the square, and side AR is equal to side RC. These are also the sides of square. So by RHS, these two triangles will be congruent, which would imply that AS is equal to QC and AS is nothing but QC we know is 55 centimeters, so AS is 55 centimeters. Now we have to find out BS, which is nothing but AS plus AB. And AB we know is the side of the square, which is 27. So AS is 55. So this becomes 55 plus 27, which is 82 centimeters. So BS is equal to 82 centimeters. Moving to the next question, express this given expression in the simplest form. So let's first of all now we write this numerator as such, but it is divided by this expression. We write the first expression, this one as such, and then divide by something. Now instead of divide by, we can now say it is multiplied by the reciprocal of it. So this becomes a minus a square minus b square square root divide by square root of a square plus b square minus b. Now we use the identity x minus y into x plus y is equal to x square minus y square. So in the numerator it becomes a square minus b square. Divide by, in the denominator it becomes a square plus b square minus b square. So this is nothing but b square and this is nothing but a square. So the value of this expression in the simplest form is b square by a square. Moving to the last question of this session, and this is also the last question of the paper. There are only two questions in a maths test. Problem 1 was solved by 70% of the students. Problem 2 was solved by 60% of them. Every student solved at least one of the problems. 9 students solved both the problems. How many students appeared in the test? So let's take the total students to be X. So students who solved problem 1, that is 70%, so 0.7x. Now problem 2 solved by 0.6x. Now there are 9 students who solved both. So 9 students are appearing in 0.7x also and 0.6x also. So they are occurring 2 times. So we can say if we subtract 9 from this, we get a total of x. So we can express it in the Venn diagrams also. If this is 0.7x and this circle is 0.6x, then this number is 9, which is adding up twice. So we'll subtract it once and we get the total number of students as x. So this gives us 0.3x is equal to 9. So x comes out to be 30. So this is the total number of students who appeared for the test are 30. Friends, you can visit us at our Cool Smart Learning website and subscribe to our YouTube channel to get updates on the new sessions.